Should be another new hike today with Eric. We're in Tepoztlán. This is Tierra Blanca is where we're going.
Supposedly.
Hopefully. This is a place I've known about, or we've known about, for at least a couple of years, but haven't been able to get to because we haven't had any idea where it is. But it's across, not across the preposition, but across the religious thing, on the top of a peak, kind of on the other side of the mountain of Tepozteco Pyramid. And I've seen pictures of it on Instagram and social media, and I thought it looked really cool. Tried messaging the people who took the pictures to ask them for information, but never got any reply, and I posted comments and nobody replied, so Eric has found an app that is hopefully going to help us. So
that will take us somewhere, but we're not sure that it's the cross.
Yeah, we're going to end up doing a good hike. It just might not be newer what we want it to be, but we'll do something. So we're in the forest now. This is Calle de los Conejos, kind of in Tepoztlán. And it's very cloudy today, overcast, and let's see what happens.
We're close to making a right.
We're off to a good start. We've pretty much found, at least for now, where we want to go. Here's the pyramid right here. That's Tepozteco Pyramid, which has been closed since the pandemic began and remains closed. Although I think recently it's been closed, not because of the pandemic, but just because. Eric and I were just talking about that they close things in Mexico or change something and then kind of forget that they made that change and never change it back. And we haven't seen anybody all day, and I don't expect that we will. And I know we're going in the right direction because we're both very familiar with this area and we know where that cross is. And we're definitely headed in the right direction. We're going up, which is good. And we know it's on this side of the pyramid.
Up.
Yeah, up is better.
Yeah. And also on the little map, here is a kind of a loop starts.
So okay.
The thing was that this one came down the other.
I wonder if the cross is up. I think it's further than this, no?
I don't think so.
I know it kind of. The cross is in a part that kind of juts out.
Yeah.
into the town.
But it could be over there, because I don't see any more ridges on that side. This has been walked as well. This is the main trail clearing. shore.
Oh yeah, I see a bunch of vultures. Camera can't pick it up, but there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yeah, 7. And what a great sky, dark, horrible looking here. And then the town is bathed in sunlight.
Get a Tlacotenco on the clouds. Just below the cloud line, you can see.
That's San Juan Tlacotenco. No cross yet, but I can smell it. I can smell the religion.
And lightning's gonna strike you if you keep talking.
I feel like it's over here.
I
from the pictures I've seen, I feel like it should be right there. Because
yep.
It does jut out into the town. This is Tepoztlan here. And from what I've seen in the pictures, the peak that the cross is on sticks out into the town, as this does.
the cross.
There's a pass. That's it, way down there?
Way down there.
Ah, yeah, I see the actual, I can see the cross.
Yeah, exactly. The cross is there.
So we're way higher than we expected.
Yep.
But not at the cross.
But we have a fantastic
view. This is a great view. Yeah, look at the pyramid here. And what are those people on the pyramid? Do you see three?
Garbage cans.
Oh, is it?
I thought, hey, it's open again.
Yeah, because I see some white discoloration. Wow, what a view. So we're way higher than the cross. I don't know if the camera can pick it up, but the cross is right there. So kind of a win-lose.
Yep.
But it does stick out into the town, as I thought. And now it's getting hot and sunny.
Funny, and the people whose hike you were following, they didn't go here.
Oh, on your app?
Yeah, they turned back. They turned left when they reached up. They didn't go right, so they didn't come to this place.
Going over here now. We agreed that this was maybe the best view of Tepoztlán we've ever had. Of all the times we've come here, all different angles, different elevations and heights and everything, this was a really, really good view because we get to see these mountains here behind us, which we're always on that, so we don't see it, and the town too. So we're gonna go, and pretty easy to get here if you have a little bit of resourcefulness. And didn't take us long from where we parked the car. Took like an hour and 15 minutes of very easy hike. And we had to turn around once or twice. I think this part that we're going to now, we'll get a good view of the town, but probably not a view of the pyramid. I think it'll be blocked by the section that we were just on. All right, here we go. Yeah, I can't see the pyramid from here or the mountains. Yeah, funny, we just walked a minute and a half and the view is not nearly as good. Could go to this one too.
I'm not sure.
Somehow.
There's a trail. There's a little trail that will probably take you there.
Nice sky today too.
Yes.
It was cloudy and miserable at 7 o'clock when I woke up, and maybe even more miserable when I met Eric. And but the last half hour or so has gotten pretty nice. All right, we're gonna try this one.
So you wanna have a look at the other one?
Yeah, let's take a look.
Yeah, maybe you get a bit farther right, so maybe you see the pyramid again.
Yeah. I can see Galerias Cuernavaca. You can see that, the big concrete tower that looks like a like a horizontal L. That's the building that they built beside Mega. What do they call it? Not Mega La Selva. Mega, the one across the street from Galerias Cuernavaca. Yeah. So this is all Cuernavaca here. And that's, I don't know if I can see where I'm pointing at, but that's Galerias Cuernavaca. You can see the white tents of Galerias, the three white pointy tents. All right, let me try going up here.
Yep.
You see them? Made my knees weak. This is like a giant chasm here.
And a little rock is just
with his rock as the bridge. This is all really, really deep chasm. Oh man, that made me quiver. Oh my god, that's a long, long way down. Alright, this is gonna be a one step. And over. Ha! Ah. You see how deep that is?
Man,
it makes you think differently, yeah?
Yep.
All right, I'll shut up. That's like the easiest thing. Yeah? Man, it fucks you up. That should be nothing going across that rock.
True.
But then when you see that it's, I don't know how many meters down, it it plays with you. You can try going up here first. Ah, there's a trail here. You don't have to go straight up. All right. Oh yeah. Oh, lovely.
It's another town, Mirador. Which we would be very excited about if we hadn't seen that first one a couple
of
minutes ago.
And again, there's the cross. I don't know if I'm pointing at it in the video, but it's around there.
Yeah, our goal of today, which we're far away from. But okay, this is a goal for the next hike.
Ah, oh, this looks cool.
This is fantastic.
Excellent. Oh, right beside the pyramid. Look at that. You never know what you're going to find when you walk around a little bit. Doesn't take much. This took about 3 or 4 minutes off the trail. Big cornfield. I gotta take a run at that. Yes. Ah, this is excellent. Oh, you got your umbrella caught?
so from here.
Going back down?
I guess so, yeah.
Yeah. Finished on the way back to the car. Excellent hike today, no?
Fantastic, yeah.
Very good one. Yeah. We were, as I said in the beginning of the video, hoping to find the cross. Didn't find it. It was exactly where we thought it would be, but it wasn't there, as shown. But I think everything we saw was better. We had, what did we go to, about five or six miradores?
Yeah, a couple, quite a few.
Yeah. Good views, views we've never seen before, different angles. We were up pretty high, so we're walking through the forest now, almost back to the car. This is a good one. So still, so we did Tepoztlán, I don't know, about a month ago, and that was also, a good part of that was new, and a good part of this one was new also. So always good to have new adventures, and once you do it once, you've got that data in your brain forevermore. And you can use it whenever you like. Free. Your brain is the best app that you can have. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Is that an animal?
I don't know. It
sounded like something up in the trees.
There's no river, so probably an animal, yeah. But I hear music, so maybe a guy is working in the fields. But it is making a lot of noise. So
yeah, it is.
Cows or something.
Yeah, it's a lot of noise.
It's too much noise to be a koala. That's for sure.
Yeah, always disappointing that we don't see animals. We saw a couple of squirrels, lots of vultures, and a couple of squirrels, and no coatis. Haven't seen a coati since I've been on the pyramid, which has been, I guess, close to a year and a half at this point. Anyway, so I do believe that is all from an excellent, very easy and very rewarding hike in, where? In Tepoztlán, I guess we could call it, right?
It's Tepoztlán, yeah, yeah. Between Tepoztlán and San Juan Tlacotenco.
Yeah, this Calle de los Conejos is on the road that connects Tepoztlán to San Juan Tlacotenco, both of which we have done many times. So that's it. Over and out.
That's another one, the one you want to do a bigger hike from Tlacotenco.